Hey, this is YBR with Automation, the car company tycoon gamer. We are going to do the very last scenario where we build a car. We've done all of them up until this one, and this is the last one, the iCar. Now, before we do this, I just want to say, after this, I'm probably going to do some sandbox stuff, but I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do in the sandbox. So I'm going to ask you guys to leave your ideas and stuff in the comments, and depending on what you guys want to see the most, that's what we'll do in the sandbox. So anyways, this one is iCar. A while back, you designed an engine for a certain IT company's automotive debut. Guess what? It's 1 year old already. 1 year too old. Man, that really does sound like an iCar. The executives decided to replace this car by a completely new one, and they shredded the blueprints for the old engine. Apart from rampant fanboys, no one really liked their iFuel idea, and they didn't even bother to ask engineers if common fuels could be adapted. While you somehow managed to persuade the executives to include windows in the model, it needs a sleek design, a marketing buzzword for bland, and that means no unnecessary grills. Okay, let's go iCar then. Alright, so this is, let's look at what we gotta do. We have the year is 2014. Fuel, we need comfort, prestige, quite a bit of money. Cooling, no cooling really, that is gonna, okay, that's weird, no cooling. Alright, we need tameness, sportiness, safety, economy, and reliability are more important though. So based on the money we have, or based on the year 2014 first off, they don't make ladder chassis cars really anymore, so monocoque it is. It's just that simple. They don't make them like that anymore, so that's why it won't be that. Material, it seems like glued aluminum is just so great because it's lightweight and reasonably cheap. With $9,500, we should be able to afford that. Engine placement, this is an economy car after all, so front transverse. And since tameness and sportiness are important, you know what we're going to do? Double wishbone front and back. That is what we're doing. Double wishbone front and back, which is, you know, this is like when Honda used to make good cars. They would throw double wishbone front and back for grandma. You know, grandma don't really care if it has double wishbone front or back, front and back, but they used to do that in their cars just because, and man, they just haven't been the same since they stopped doing that. It's just, those were the cool ones. Those were when Honda made cool cars. They're cooler, at least. Now it's, whatever. So anyways, we're going to use all-wheel drive on this because, again, I'm pretty sure that makes it more tame and sporty. And that's what they say is important, so that's what we're building. And panel material, let's go with polymer. Again, the glued aluminum polymer combination seems to work very well for me, so we're going to stick with it for now. And again, we're going to just, by the way, for the quality sliders right here, I'm not going to mention them, but I'm always going to put them up to zero tech unless something else happens. I won't say anything when I do it, though, just because it gets repetitive. Anyways, we could choose a body style now. We got this one, which, that looks okay. Kind of reminds me a little bit of a Nissan Leaf, just a bit. And we got this one, which is, it looks more like a van. I don't want a van. I want a little bit more of a sedan hatchback look thing like this. That looks better. I like this one better. All right, so, you know what? You know what I'm just thinking, though? BMG really needs that generic, kind of beige-ish brown bland color you see on old people cars. You know what I'm talking about. You know what I mean? That really bland color, that it doesn't have it, man. It needs it. It doesn't have one like that. So this is as close as it gets, I guess. So we'll use that color. And what shape do we want this body, huh? Let's make it stubby. All right, what is this? Ooh, that looks weird. Okay, let's think. So when the normal person goes to park their car, if they have a really long front end, they'll probably just smash up their front end when they try to parallel park, so we'll make that nice and short and stubby. We'll make this probably go downwards more, because that way it's easier to see the road for the driver, so they can see what they're doing before they crash. And let's see, can we make this, well, that doesn't change much, so we'll leave it at the way it was at the start. And move that up, because that looks a little too sloped. It's just a ton of slope right there. Well, look at that, that looks insane. It's like, that is a crazy looking design, so let's do it like that. It looks more reasonable, I guess you could say. So there we go. And that front door just looks huge. That window right here, it looks huge, so I want to make it smaller. I still want to make it smaller, but it won't let me. So that is the size it'll be, because that just looks like a big piece of glass. And let's see, what else can we do? Ooh, we can make this thing, ooh, that really changes the look from like a van to a car. It's kind of an ugly car though, that is for sure. This is one ugly thing I'm making. Oh well, let's try to make it, we'll try to save it, man. Try to make it look a little bit better. It looks okay. You know, I'm just trying to say, you gotta have nice visibility so everybody, you can see where you're going, you don't crash and die. Very important. You don't need big bumpers in the back, that just looks dumb. Unless you need a place to sit, maybe, like if you're tailgating. you inflate your bumper, you go and it inflates out, and then you can sit on it, right? Instead of opening the hatch, you know, because that's way too much effort. Is that a hatch or is that just a trunk? I really can't tell. I guess it's just a trunk, actually. See, it looks like it'd be more suitable for a hatch in this design, but oh well. And that'll work. You know, it's just a very bland car. And that'll work, man. That'll work. All right. Headlights. We need some headlights. We need some 2014 kind of headlights. Like these ones. They look pretty 2014. Except that angle is terrible. Whoop, whoop. Nah, scratch that. They don't match the body style. They don't match it. They just don't. We need headlights that match. Oops, I meant to click the ones next to that. That looks also really weird. Ooh! We could put them down here as like fog lights or something. I don't know. I just think they kind of look neat down there. Because they match the body style. They don't make any sense. They just look good down there. So we need to make it make sense. Unfortunately, I don't really like any of these lights. I don't like any of them. I just don't like them. So, maybe we don't need lights. This is the car of the future. It has pop-up lights. Pop-up lights are making a comeback. That is my excuse. Yes, we're going to put a vent and just call them pop-up lights. Because you can't tell me what to do. Let's see, what would look like a pop-up light vent? How about this thing? No. I don't care. You can't tell me how to design a car. Pop-up lights are making a comeback someday. I wish they would. I love pop-up lights. Oh, this will work perfect. So just go... No, it doesn't look right, does it? What about this one? Oh, there we go. That's what's up. That's it. See, pop-up lights. It's making a comeback. That's what those are. You can't tell me how to design a car. I'm going to do a quick pause real quick, and I'll be right back, though. Okay, so what I did is I looked up the Nissan Leaf, because I did mention this kind of reminded me of a Nissan Leaf. I'm like, how do they do their headlights? And I looked it up, and it's like, yeah, that's kind of hideous, too. So I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with the headlights. I went ahead and took off the pop-up lights idea. And, well, I'm not really sure what to do, because I don't like headlights on this car at all. I almost want to put no headlights, but instead of just doing that, I'm just going to throw some on and say that's it. They're good. Kind of looking like the Nissan Leaf style, just because that's what I said. How do they do it? And theirs is just weird. Their whole car, that is a weird looking car. Looking at it, man, it's a weird car. So we're just going to set the lights like that, and that'll be that. And now we need a grill. We need a real tiny grill, like a little tiny grill. That is a huge grill in comparison to what we need. We need just a little hole. Maybe it would be better if we have like a little sliver. Maybe that would work. So, oh, wait, actually, I got an even better idea. What if we just used vents for the thing like that? Oh, that actually looks kind of nice. I can't have more than 100 cooling, though, so there goes that kind of niceness. There we go. That looks all right. Look at that. It looks fancy and sleek like they wanted. That's all the cooling the engine needs. That feels so wrong. That feels so wrong, man. It feels like there should be a lot more cooling. Always feels like there should be more cooling, though, if I'm designing it. That's the thing. Do we need a bonnet thing like for our huge engine? You know what? Let's put that in there and let's put a V8 in it. We're going to put a V8 in our economy car. You can't tell me what to do. It's V8 time. We are putting a V8 in it. It's a V8. It's a V8. I don't care. It is V8 time. So let's see. Does this need indicators on the front? Might as well. You can't really see them, so we could just... I kind of like them right there. That looks fine. A little more. There we go, that works. You can now see the indicator a little bit, so that's good. What else do we got? Headlights. We need some taillights now. And I should probably look up what the Nissan Leaf had. It has some weird things, doesn't it? It has like some vertical thing that goes like all the way through here or something. Yeah, I don't think I could do that. And the reason I just keep bringing up that car is, again, that's what the body style reminded me of. See, it has like up here or something, if I remember correctly. And, well, that's not working, as you can see. That doesn't happen. Game's like, you don't do this. Trying to move it up there, but it doesn't seem to want it to go there. Yeah, see? So that's no good. Let's just shove some taillights right here in this area. What kind of matches the shape? We'll go with, let's go with these in the bottom. Make them a little bit bigger. A little bit more. There, something like that, maybe. That looks okay. I'm okay with that. That looks fine. Just a little bit more. Try to make it look like it's one piece just on the edge. Perfect. That actually looks reasonable for taillights in the first time ever. fairly reasonable. What if we put taillights on top of our tail? You know, I'm just going to ruin them by doing that. I shouldn't even try about that. I should just stop. It looks fine. Don't do anything dumb. Just leave it happy and pretty. Okay? Don't do anything dumb. So let's go ahead and add a license plate bumper piece thing here. So we're going to go whoop. Let's make it nice and tall. Let's go U.S. size bumper or license plate. So go like that. Perfect. And we're going to put a badge on it. Whoa. That is a badge. I just thought of something. I never put handles on the back. I never do. Can you even? Okay, you can't. That's my excuse for never having a handle to open up the trunk of things. The game won't allow you to. Yes, that is why I always forgot them up until this point. It's totally because the game won't allow you to do it. It's not because I forgot. What are you talking about? Okay, I totally forgot about putting handles in the back. I have no idea how, because normally a lot of cars will have a handle in the back, especially one like this. Where it has, oh, I guess it's not a hatchback. That's right, it's a trunk. But still, a lot of cars have handles. I'm pretty sure. I think. Yeah. Yeah, they do. I'm thinking now. Yeah, quite a few cars do. So what else can we do? Don't need wings, but we do need handles on the car itself. Just very basic, bland handles. Well, no. Let's do something a little fancier. Let's go with these ones that stick out with the shininess. Yeah, shiny handles. Yeah, ooh, look at that. So 2014 and sleek, like an iCar. And the handles should be in line with each other. It just seems weird if they're not. The doors are weird. Look at this. The back door is so much taller than the rear. That is just odd. That is very odd. Okay, there we go. And let's see. We got handles. We don't need a wing. Although I remember, man, you could make a beastly car in Forza when you put a wing on the Nissan Leaf. You could make one amazing car for no good reason. But no, we don't need that. Bonnet. We already got the power, man. That is going to shove up. We're going to shove a V8 in there. I mean it. We're going to shove a V8 into this thing. So with all that power, we need some big exhaust. So, yeah, that is an exhaust. That is like a monster. Are we shoving rocket engine into this thing or what? There you go. Let's make it reasonable. I mean, it is a V8 after. I don't know why I want a V8 in it. I just want a V8 in it. I want a V8. You can't tell me what to do. I want a V8. I want a lip too. It'll make it more gas efficient or something maybe. Because aerodynamics and stuff. One lip down. Put a lip in the front, too. We need a badge in the front as well. Looks kind of bland. Yeah, look at that aerodynamics, man. And let's get a badge. What kind of badge do we use in the back? I totally forgot. Okay, looks like it's, this one. Got it. Wait a minute. I just realized something. This is slightly different. This badge has the corner on the left. They mirror the badge on the front and the back, so it's a different badge, actually. How weird is that? All right, so there we go. That is a fairly reasonable-looking car. It looks a little unusual because it's like I want it to be a race car with a V8, so it has V8 influences, but it still looks somewhat like an economy car. And really, the question is, will a V8 work? And, no, probably not, but I don't care. We're going to use a V8 in it, man. I said V8. We're using a V8. Well, I got some unfortunate news. The game managed to crash somehow, so what I did is I remade the car to the best of my abilities. It may look ever so slightly different, but for the most part, it looks like the same car that it was before. It looks like that kind of weird car that looks like it wants to be a sports car, but it also wants to be an economy car kind of abomination thing. And I remade it looking at the video from the last one, so it should be pretty close. Now, anyways, going back to the engine. Let's make an engine. We're going to use a V8 cast iron because it's cheap. And we're not going to do V-flat plane, I don't think, because I don't know. For now, we won't use V-flat plane. And unfortunately, oh man, the engine's already too big. So let's do this. We'll max out the stroke until it says it's too big. Actually, no, we should do that later, because if we do that now, when we add parts, see, like there, it's too big because we use a cast iron crank. Or apparently. I guess it's not. It's just adding parts makes things bigger. So we'll add all the parts, then we'll size the engine up. So let's go cast iron crank though, because we're not going to make that much torque. It's an economy car, sort of. It's sort of an economy car. Anyway, let's see, cast conrod, same thing. It's not going to make that much torque or that high of RPMs, probably. And we need the low friction cast pistons. This thing is an economy car. Right here, economy. We need economy. There we go. The low friction cast pistons will do that for us. Heads and valves. For the best economy, we're going to use a 5-valve setup. again, cast iron, because it's just cheap and it's simple, and it usually works well. Compression, we'll come back to later. Cam profile, we'll raise that up a bit. Why not? Put variable valve timing on. We can't have VVO because we didn't use four valves, so that's fine. Just don't use it. That looks good. No turbo. This is not a turbo machine. We have a V8. We don't need a turbo. We have a V8. It's that simple. Injection system. And, you know, let's go all out. Let's do a direct injection system. No throttle per cylinder or nothing. Just a single direct injection system should do pretty good for fuel economy. And intake, performance, man. We got a V8 in here. This is a performance economy car. Put that performance intake on it. And we're going to use super unleaded. And let's see. We're going to reduce the fuel mixture down as lean as we can go. Probably increase the ignition timing as high as we can go because we need that economy. And that I think it'll work. I don't know. Increase the RPM limit some. Go and increase the quality some. And that should be good. All right, headers. Let's do long tubular just because long tubular looks so nice. It's so nice. Tubular, it looks okay. But long tubular is some beautiful stuff. And single exhaust or dual. We have dual exhaust set up on the car, so dual makes sense. Bypass valve I won't bother with for now. Exhaust diameter, we're probably going to need to increase that a bit. I don't know how much power this is going to make, honestly. Figure that out later. No muffler, no catalytic converter, none of that stuff. Up that slider. And let's see, will you run? And it's going to run. You can tell by the dynograph. It spoils it, man. I should just not look. I'm covering it up with my hand, right? It's running, look at that. Don't you wish you had an economy car with a V8 that made 200 and something horsepower? I know you do. The question is, will we be able to get platinum using something like this? Probably not. Well, definitely not. But that's okay. First off, we gotta reduce the size. This thing is way too big. And usually it seems like for economy, large stroke, low bore is ideal. I don't know if that's necessarily always true, but that seems to usually be the case for when I'm building an engine. Large stroke, low bore equals a fairly economical engine. So we're gonna just increase the stroke until the thing says this engine is too big. And I don't know how long that's going to take, so we'll just do it. There we go. And then, all right, there we go. And perfect. Oh, perfect. There we go. Okay. Let's see what that does. How much power does that make? Slightly more, but not by much. Ooh. The cooling is going to kill me. I only have 100. That's right. I only have 100 kilojoules of cooling. This thing's just going to overheat and fry itself off. It's going to fry itself up, and that's no good. Oh, man, there's nothing really, as far as I know, there's nothing you can really do to make an engine run cooler. Maybe if you use different materials in it, that might help, but I'm not sure if it'll help much. Yeah, it helps a little bit. Unfortunately, I think the only solution that I know of that I know will work is to make the engine smaller. So, I'm sorry, big V8, you're going to be a tiny V8. How small can you make it? Oh, look at the little V8. It's so cute. It is the cutest V8 I have ever seen. Look how tiny it is. Oh, look at its little valves. That is cute. I want a little V8. Yeah, my little V8. It'll work out, hopefully. I saw the compression was really low. We could up that a ton. See what that does. And it's going to make only like 80 horsepower at most from a V8. But the V8 is so tiny. It's a little baby V8. I think it's cute. Really cute. It sounds good for a little baby V8. 60 horsepower. That's nothing. It's like no power at all from a V8. It just sounds so funny. Yeah, my V8 makes 60 horsepower. We could up the compression a bit more, it looks like, because, I think we could do that. And economy is actually really good. Look at that economy, man. I'm in economic V8 again. I'm good at that for some reason. So let's go and up the compression a couple more clicks. And what else can we do? This stuff, we'll have to mess with this probably in a little bit. Leave it the way it is for now. And let's see, is that good? Is that rating good? All right, we're right there at the octane rating. We have 93 octane fuel. 92.9 is right where we want to be. So this engine is done. That is my little baby V8. Who's a cute V8? Yes, you are. Hopefully it'll work out. I don't know if it's, I don't think it will. I mean, it's cool to have a baby V8, but I don't think it'll work. So let's just put an automatic transmission in with 8 gears. And spacing, I don't ever know what to do with for sure, so we'll leave it right there for now. I'll come back to that later. Top speed, max that thing out. 281 mile per hour. Yeah, with 63 horsepower. How's that going to happen? I don't know. All right, tires. Let's give it some fat tires. Why? I don't know. Fat tires, man. Got to get that grip because we need sportiness. I don't know why we need sportiness, but that is why we put all these sporty elements in it. So we're going to put semi-slicks on it for maximum sportiness and make the wheels really big in diameter so we can put some huge rims on this thing. Yeah, 20-inch rims. That's what's up. Look at that. It looks like a bicycle tire. That's terrible, but it's okay. It's okay. Get some offset, man. That's what we need. Oh, we can't. It won't do offset. We're already at the limits. Oh, that is a great-looking car. Sarcasm. A solid disc brake, two piston. Solid disc brake, two piston. And pad type, I'm not sure, so we'll leave it like that. Big brakes are always good to keep you alive. I need my customers coming back to complain and then buy more stuff, maybe, if I'm lucky. Under tray, fully clad for maximum miles per gallon. Get those brakes nice and cool, because this engine doesn't need much cooling. It's the world's smallest V8. How much does it need? 50 kilojoules, we're good. Aero inclination, I won't touch that for now. Get some sliders up, and four seats. Basic interior, insulation, we'll see. I don't know how much comfort we're going to have. And prestige, all that will determine this stuff. So we're just going to leave it all basically blank for now, and we'll come back to it. So blank, blank, blank. But we will put advanced safety in, because safety is one of the things where it's hugely important. So make it a priority. Suspension, let's go race and then jack it up, because that always seems to be a good strategy. Put it at 8 maybe. And how's that do? All right, we need more comfort and more prestige. A lot more comfort, a little more prestige. So comfort, we can get that by adding more insulation, increasing the interior quality. And how does that do? All right, it's better, but it still has quite a ways to go. I think the assist will help with comfort if we put all of these in the car. So we can go ahead and do that. And comfort is at 22.2. It's getting better, but we still have a bit of a ways to go. What about breaking the brakes down to be comfort brakes? Does that help? It should. There we go. That's another point. We're getting there. We're getting there. All right. What else can we do for comfort? Let's see here. Well, you know, as weird as it sounds, what if we had smaller tires? Would that help? I'm not sure. Ooh, we could get some rim offset now, though. Yeah. I don't know why. Just because we can. Does that help comfort? It does. Sportiness is down, though. Oh, well. It'll work, hopefully. If we up the offset a little bit more, does that also help comfort? Yes, it does, but not by a measurable amount. Automatic gearbox should be ideal for comfort already, so I won't touch that. And, I'm not sure how we could get comfort up much more without really blowing money. I mean, I guess we could increase the interior quality, but I don't know. Oh, entertainment. We should throw some of that in. That'll help a bunch. Oh, there we go. Oh, my goodness. It's too expensive. This is going to be rough, isn't it? And it's still not enough comfort. Well, first, let's reduce the cost. I guess if we were to maybe make it steel, maybe AHS steel, and aluminum, that'll be cheaper enough where we might be okay. How does that do? Still a little too expensive, huh? That is not good. That is a scary thing. How can I reduce the cost more? I could get rid of the double wishbone, but I really don't want to do that. I really like my double wishbones, man. You don't just get rid of your double wishbone. Uh-uh. Where can we reduce the cost? Okay, yeah. We could definitely reduce the cost here. If we put a standard intake, that might help. Just tubular would probably be more than enough. In fact, this exhaust should probably be really tiny. Like, really, really tiny. In fact, I think dual might be kind of overkill. I think we might run better if we just have a real tiny single exhaust. Yeah, we run better with a single exhaust because the engine is so small. And that reduces the cost a bit, I think. All right, it's getting there. We still need the cost lower, though. All right, I want my V8 engine. I don't care. I'm not changing the V8 engine. I want a V8 engine in my economy car. You won't tell me how to run my business. This is the YBR makes V8 engines and puts them in whatever business, Incorporated, LLC. I don't know. If there was rotary engines, I'd just shove those in everything, but there isn't. So that's why everything gets a V8. Let's see. I mean, doing the tech sliders on those won't save much money. That is the truth of the matter. It won't save that much. We need to save money somewhere else, and I'm not sure where. How much does that cost me? See, that slider, $14. That's really nothing. I'm not too worried about that. What about, all right, what if we tried to get rid of some of the assist, maybe? I think electronic stability won't affect comfort too much because I don't want to kill the comfort too hard. Sportiness went up, tameness went down, price went down, but it's still not down enough. Wait a minute, why did I have this tech slider up so high? I have no idea why I had that thing up so high. Well, there is a huge cost right there. All right, now the comfort's down though. So for comfort, let's go back over here. And we could do electronic stability control doesn't do anything for comfort. We could put the quality slider up on the interior one. And comfort is slightly up, but not as much as I would hope. So we need to do something else to get comfort up, and I'm not exactly sure what to do. Go and put that down for now. What if we just do comfort suspension setup? It didn't really help. It's the same as it was before, so keep the old setup then. Let's see. Everything here looks pretty decent. I mean, we could do interior, but we don't have enough money to really do it on that. I'm looking for something that's cheap to change. Nice and cheap. I wonder if the discs could be too big. Is that possible? Like, the disc is so big it reduces comfort because it breaks too good. Is it? Nope, big disc brakes are good. As expected. Alright, what if we did the spacing? Huge spacing on the gearbox. Comfort went down, okay. Really small spacing. Comfort stayed neutral, so 50 is about ideal on this, so that's not gonna get us anywhere. Unfortunately. Let's see. Alright, here's where the hard part comes in. What are we gonna change? Oh, that's hard. Let me look through everything real quick and I'll get right back at you guys so I can figure out exactly what's on this thing. Ah, here we go. Here's all the comfort points we lost. I didn't put a muffler on it. So if we throw some reverse flows on it, that should just shoot the comfort up. There we go. Ooh, right into gold. I love when that happens. All right, now we just gotta tweak it to get into platinum. How are we gonna do that? Let's see here. Do we need both of these mufflers? Maybe, maybe not. I'm not really sure. We'll leave it just the way it is. I'm not gonna touch it. Just don't touch it. And let's see, since we have a, how much comfort do we have? Okay, we have some comfort to work with now. We don't need 39 comfort. That's too much. So let's throw in a sequential gearbox because that'll up the sportiness, which should help overall. There we go, another 21 points. What if we lower the top speed? Because that top speed is just absurd and unusable. No change overall. The miles per gallon did go down. We're getting 70 miles per gallon on a V8. I do like that. That is nice. 70 gallon miles per gallon with my V8. 72. Ooh, it went up to a little bit. So I guess a little, if you go too high, it's too much, too low, too little. What about V flat plane? Is it any better in this situation? I never know exactly which situation to use which. And it does help a little bit, that is good. And we have $400 to blow to get just a little bit of points. So this should be pretty easy. What about electronic stability? There we go. We just need like $2. Or I mean we need 2 points. So if we just go up one slider on anything, it should be good. Oh, come on. 1270 and 1270, that's not good enough for you. Huh. Fine, I'll put it up again. Yeah, now what you gonna do? You better give me that platinum. There we go. That is my V8, man. Yeah, V8. V8, man. Got a V8. That is so dumb. I just had to have my V8. I don't care about anything other than having a V8. So I'm gonna go and lower that slider. And I wanna try to make the engine a little bit bigger. Because the poor V8 is so tiny. It's cute. It's very cute, but it is so tiny. We have enough cooling for a slightly bigger V8. Reduce the compression. So this one is not going to get platinum, mind you. This is just, I want a V8 this fast. And this is my car, I do what I want. See, it's going down in score, but look at that, it's faster. I think the sportiness went up, so it has to be faster, right? Right? That makes sense. Make it bigger. Make it bigger. Bigger V8. I think we have about 80 kilojoules of cooling to use. Required cooling is going to be right there, right about the limit right here for this one. So this is a. It's gonna be it for in terms of size right here. See, the car can only cool just so make it. If we use the magnesium, that'll cool it off a little bit more. And the aluminum silicone, those should make it where it runs cooler. Oh, it runs hotter with that? Weird. Okay, what if we do aluminum silicone on both? Huh. Maybe aluminum on both? I know some. I swear another head material ran things cooler. Maybe it's because the engine's knocking. Maybe that's just changing things up a little. Oh, now the cooling is worse now that it's not knocking. Well, fine, engine, be that way. Girl. You pain? Alright, aluminum silicone again. Not any cooler. Just more expensive. Fine, don't use that then. Get the cast iron back. Cast iron's good. Cast iron skillets, man. Those are great, so why wouldn't cast iron engines be great? Makes sense to me. What if you put a bypass valve on it? That doesn't help at all. Doesn't help one bit. Do I care if the engine overheats, though? Nah. Meh. Oh, but I do care if the cost gets too high. Is it because of the bypass valve? How expensive is that thing? How did I get the price up so high? Oh. Duh. The cast iron in your engine ain't free, you dummy. All that engine parts is expensive. Steel everywhere so we can afford a bigger V8. Yeah, a bigger V8. I love the fact that I just have a giant V8 in here and it still passes. So yeah, V8 power. So look at that. Yeah, V8 power. How much horsepower is this thing making right now? I'm hoping for at least 200. Oh, it's knocking hard. If it wasn't knocking, it'd be doing pretty good, I bet. Lower the compression some. We'll let it run this one out. I know it's going to knock based on the dyno chart, but I never let it knock, so I'll let you hear it knock. Oh, it didn't. I was thinking it would knock and die. This time I think it just knocked a little bit while it was going up. Yeah, see? That's surprising. Going to lower the compression a little bit. And there we go. That is good. Only 134 horsepower, though. Oh, well. Oh, no. The economy's not good enough. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. No, no, no. Put the polymer back. Okay, is that? I ruined this car now. I have absolutely ruined it. I used to have this car that was really good and efficient, and then I wanted a bigger V8. And things went terribly downhill. Terribly, terribly downhill. So, that's it. Obviously, you can't shove a bigger V8 into this. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. The game says, no, this is really dumb. You can't shove a big V8 into this. And I'm like, all right, game, if you say so, we won't put a big V8 in it. I want one, but I can't, so I won't. Hey, there we go. Wow, bypass valves are really good for sporting this, apparently. Should have threw one in earlier. So we got platinum, though. That's what I like to do, is get that platinum, man. Makes me feel like I know what I'm doing, even though I have no idea what I'm doing at all. Put that aero inclination. Oh, no, 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 no. Aero inclination, wrong way. Put it down. Get that economy up. Yeah. 73 miles per the gallon with my V8, the world's tiniest V8. Can you see? I think you can see the V8 in here. If you line up the camera right, you should be able to see it. The hard part's lining up the camera. There needs to be like an open hood button. That'd be great. Just so you can actually see it. Because you can, it's actually in there. Look, there it is. Look how tiny it is. It's the cutest V8 ever. Oh my god, look at it. It's so cute. Oh, it is the cutest V8 ever. And it's so low to the ground and stuff. I love it. It's just hilarious how tiny it is. It's like the baby V8. So, yep, I did a V8 for the economy car. Can't tell me what to do. And I got platinum. So, till next time, it's been YBR. I'll see ya.